Hey, it's Ross from rossluckman.com. Today I want to talk to you about how to connect these RuuviTags to the Cerbo GX wirelessly so we can bring in things like temperature, humidity, and air pressure from all around our van or RV. We can measure the temperature of the freezer or the refrigerator. We can measure the temperature of a water tank underneath the vehicle, your engine bay. Whatever you want, we can wirelessly bring in that data to the Cerbo GX. This was a recent firmware update where it can now take in data from Bluetooth LE or low energy devices. And we can look at that data here locally on the Cerbo GX. If we're connected to the Victron remote management portal, we can also upload the sensor data to the portal and we can graph and see the temperature of, say, our freezer over time and see from day to day what that temperature fluctuation is. And lastly, we can also connect to the relays here and we can have the temperature sensors set off various functions. So what I have set up here is I've got a little puck light. It's run through relay 2 on the Cerbo GX. And basically I'm going to show you how to set it up where we can heat up one of the sensors and it's going to set off the light. And that's going to be a simulation for what you might do, turning on a generator, turning on your vehicle's engine, turning on a heater when it gets too cold in your battery compartment. We can do all sorts of things, and I'm gonna demonstrate that for you towards the end of the video. What I'm gonna do is start out by just showing you how to initialize one of the RuuviTags and pull the tag and activate the battery, and then I'm gonna show you where to set it up here in the Cerbo GX. And then later on in the video, I'm gonna give you additional detail, such as the difference between RuuviTag and RuuviTag Pro, and I'm going to show you how to boost the Bluetooth receptivity of the Cerbo to make sure that your Bluetooth signal is very reliable and you don't ever lose signal from the RuuviTags. So we'll get deeper into it towards the end of the video. But before we talk about how to set up the RuuviTags with the Cerbo GX, if you're interested in your overall power system, not only monitoring temperature and humidity and things like that, but also your solar power, your shore power, your alternator power. I have a resource that you may be interested in called the Ultimate Van Power Cheat Sheet. It's got a discussion of those three major charging sources, solar, shore, and alternator power. And it talks about how they all have strengths, but they each have weaknesses as well. But when you bring them together in a holistic power strategy, it's gonna make sure you have a good charge source no matter where you go out on the road, so you're not going to be running out of power or worried about running out of power, and you can enjoy your travels out there. There's also a discussion of the different battery chemistries and the strengths and weaknesses of those, and that's going to help you narrow in on which battery type is going to be right for your situation. And then lastly, there is a really cool diagram that is essentially your whole power system on one page. It's going to show the three major charging sources at the top, solar, shore, and alternator power. And it's going to show the links and connections through the system, how that power gets in and charges your batteries, and how it gets distributed to your end devices, such as your laptop or your phone charger. For instance, what are the connections between, say, your alternator and your microwave? So it's a really interesting diagram that I think you'll find useful. To get your own copy of the Ultimate Van Power Cheat Sheet, all you have to do is click that link below or go to rossluckman.com/vanpower. So with that, let's zoom in and I'm going to show you how to set up a RuuviTag with the Cerbo GX. Okay, so I've zoomed in on the GX Touch 50. This is the screen for the Cerbo GX. And what I'm going to do is I've got a RuuviTag here and it's got the little pull tab still in there, so it's not activated. Once I pull this, the battery inside will connect and it'll put out its Bluetooth signal. So we're going to leave it as is, like it came out of the box. And I'm going to go into the Cerbo GX and show you where to set this up. So we're at the main screen. We're going to tap the screen, click on menu on the bottom right, go all the way to the bottom where it says settings and click on that. And the first stop is going to be firmware. We want to make sure the firmware is up to date. I believe it was version 2.80 where the RuuviTags were able to be read by the Cerbo. So if you don't see what I'm about to show you, go to firmware and make sure that your firmware has been updated. So we're good to go here. Next up, we're going to stop at the Bluetooth setting. We're going to make sure that says enabled. And then we're going to go all the way to the bottom where it says I/O. And you can see it says analog and digital. That used to be all that was shown here, but with the new firmware update, we now have a section for Bluetooth sensors. So we're going to click on that. You're going to enable the sensors. You can kind of see the ghosts of my RuuviTags here. It's not able to pick them up because I put the tab back in there so it can't sense the battery, but I'm gonna pull this tab and you're gonna see it recognize it there on the screen. So we'll go ahead and pull that out. And you can see it pop up immediately. So we'll go ahead and set the RuuviTag aside. Let's go in and give this a better name. What we can do is hit the back button. So E432 is our sensor. If we go all the way back to the device list, you can see it says generic temperature sensor 32. And you can see we have some data already coming in. 23 degrees Celsius, 55% relative humidity. Let's click on it. And we need to go in and name it first so we know what we're dealing with. Click on device at the bottom. And you can see it says RuuviTag, Bluetooth, low energy. And where it says name, we're gonna go in and I'm gonna call this cabin temp. All right, so we gave it a custom name of cabin temp. We're gonna hit the check mark to finalize it. And now if we hit menu, it's gonna take us back to our device list and you can see cabin temp is listed there. And that is all you have to do to bring in a RuuviTag to the Cerbo GX. Now we can operate relays and we can also import this data to the VRM portal, the Victron Remote Monitoring and Management portal. I do wanna say one thing about temperature units. Currently the Cerbo GX does operate in Celsius. Victron is working on a firmware update where you can convert to Fahrenheit, but at this time, the Cerbo GX is only going to operate in Celsius units. You can convert them to Fahrenheit on the VRM portal if you use that, but here locally on this device, we are dealing with Celsius at this current time. Next up, I'm going to show you how to set off a relay using the RuuviTag as the trigger for the relay. So one of the powerful things about the RuuviTags is their ability to activate relays on the Cerbo GX. As I said earlier, I've connected our RuuviTag and programmed it to activate relay number 2, and it's gonna turn on this light when it reaches a certain set point temperature. That set point is 25 degrees Celsius. What I'm gonna do is hold it in my hand and let my body heat up the RuuviTag, and when it hits 25 Celsius, this light is gonna turn on. So what I've done is I've just run the red positive side of the light through the relay, through the normally open and common ports. And as it says, it's normally open until conditions are met and then the relay is going to close. So its internal switch is going to connect and it's going to send that power through and turn on our light. So as I said, we're at 24 Celsius. I'm going to put this in my hand and heat it up. Our light is going to turn on, and then I'm going to show you how I did the programming for this. So hopefully it doesn't take too long, but let's see what happens. All right, so our light has turned on, and it'll probably go up to 25, 26 Celsius, so it should stay on a little bit. Now I've programmed it to turn off at 24 degrees Celsius, so they're 1 degree apart. But it should stay on for a little bit. At this point, let's zoom in and I'll show you how I set that up. To have a RuuviTag set off a relay, what we want to do is click on the main screen and go to menu. Scroll down to settings. And then scroll almost to the bottom where it says relay. Click on relay. You can see there are parameters for relay 1 and relay 2. Now, relay 1 can be controlled by quite a few things. We're gonna go ahead and leave that open and go back and we're gonna deal with relay 2. So relay 2 can only be set off by temperature or it can also be set off manually, but we're gonna select temperature as the parameter and click the check mark. And now we need to go to the bottom where it says temperature control rules. So these rules apply to relay 1 and relay 2, and we're gonna give it some conditions at which point it needs to set off the relay. So you can see Any temperature sensors that you have will be displayed here. And all I have is the one RuuviTag called Cabin Temp. So we've got some conditions that I've already set up. Let's go in and look at them. Now at the top, we want to turn on relay activation on temperature to go ahead and allow temperature to set off the relays. You can see I've selected relay 2 and I've given it some conditions. So when the RuuviTag reaches 25 degrees Celsius, the relay will be activated. You can see it says inactive right now. We have not met these conditions. And then once the relay is activated at 25 degrees Celsius, when the RuuviTag cools down to 24 Celsius, the relay will deactivate and open up its contacts, and basically our light will go back off. And you can see I can set additional conditions for that RuuviTag. Let's say that I wanted the RuuviTag to also control relay 1. I could select relay 1 here and I could select additional temperature parameters. So what this might look like is relay 2 could control a heater at cold temperatures and relay 1 could control a fan at high temperatures. So there's all sorts of things that you could set up with this. But to turn our light on and off, all I did was select relay 2 and I gave it these two temperature parameters. So that's how you control a relay using a RuuviTag and the Cerbo GX. I wanted to do a quick comparison of the RuuviTag and the RuuviTag Pro. And let's start out by mentioning that the regular RuuviTag, which is about $32 at this time, actually does one additional function. It's going to do 4 different jobs, which are temperature, humidity, air pressure, and motion. And the RuuviTag Pro is going to do 3 jobs in this iteration here. You can see it has that little port, that's for humidity. So it's going to do humidity, temperature, and motion. And then there's an even more extreme Pro edition that's missing this little porthole. It's completely waterproof, but it's only going to do 2 jobs, which are temperature and motion. So as we get more extreme with the RuuviTag Pro, it's going to handle a wider temperature range, or it's going to be completely waterproof, but it's going to measure less things than the regular RuuviTag. So something to keep in mind. Now, as far as the difference in temperature ranges, the RuuviTag is going to do negative 20 degrees Celsius all the way up to 70 degrees Celsius. The RuuviTag Pro is going to do negative 40 Celsius all the way up to 85 Celsius. So it's going to go a little bit hotter and a little bit colder. But the main reason that it's going to do that is the battery that it has. So this one has the CR2477 battery. This one has the CR2477T. So we can think of the T on the end as representing extreme temperature. And if you take this battery and you put it in the regular RuuviTag, it will now do that extreme temperature range of negative 40 Celsius to 85 Celsius. So it mainly comes down to the battery. Now this one does have a more accurate temperature sensor. This is accurate to 0.2 degrees Celsius, and this is accurate to 0.1 degrees Celsius. So this is more for industrial applications, or if you just want a dead accurate reading, this one is going to be slightly more accurate, and it does have a different temperature sensor inside there. Now, as far as the mounting, obviously the RuuviTag Pro, right out of the box, we're going to be able to zip tie it to a pole. We can also screw it in place with the included screws. We can stick either one of these in place with double-sided tape. If you want to be able to zip tie and mount the regular RuuviTag, you can get this little $3 silicone sleeve. It comes with a couple of screws, and you can also zip tie it in place, and that's just going to pop right in there. Now, I do want to point out, I'll go ahead and take this sleeve off, there is an app called RuuviStation. I guess they're simulating like a weather station, but basically it's going to pull in all of your data, and you can see this RuuviTag here is showing its temperature, and then we have the other 3 parameters there on the bottom, and you can just pan through your various sensors. And the other thing you can do is set up alerts. So you can set that up for humidity, temperature, motion. You can set these up where they will trigger an alert in the app when they move. So you could stick it to a door or a vehicle door that's not supposed to move, and the app can notify you when that happens. And I will say that you can hook these up to the Cerbo GX, and you can also simultaneously pull them into the app, so you can read them in both places. But that is a quick comparison. Maybe head to RuuviTag.com to get the full rundown of the differences between these, but hopefully that helped you figure out which one or which combination of these is going to be right for your application. All right, a couple of final points on setting up the RuuviTags. I had great reception with the Bluetooth antenna inside the Cerbo GX. I was able to measure my RuuviTags up to maybe 30 feet away inside refrigerators, inside a metal box. Great reception, no problems. But some people on the Victron forum have reported reception issues, and Victron has shortlisted a few Bluetooth receivers that will boost the reception of the Cerbo GX to make sure that you always have a connection to those RuuviTags. And I've gotten the Bluetooth USB 4.0 receiver from TP-Link. I'll put a description there below. Again, I didn't need this. I bought it for this video to experiment with and see if I needed it. It's just going to plug in to the top of the Cerbo GX. But I would get your RuuviTags and test them out before you decide that you need that. If you have reception trouble, that is a route that you may want to go with. The other thing I wanted to mention was the VRM portal. If you want your RuuviTag data to not only be here locally, but also be uploaded to the portal, you can set up the VRM portal using the last video that I put out. I went through completely how to set that up and how to link your GX device to the portal to get your data uploading and allow you to access it from anywhere in the world. So I'll leave it at that. That's my review of how to link up the RuuviTags with the Cerbo GX. I hope that was helpful. Again, if you want even more help with your overall power system, you gotta grab a copy of the Ultimate Van Power Cheat Sheet. All you have to do is click that link below or go to rosslukeman.com/vanpower. So thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.